Team Hypercube viewers. We are in a new location. Space. No, we're actually at our friends, Tara and Alexander's apartment, to play Space Alert, one of our absolute favorite games, even though we're still not good at it by any means.
I think that's why it's our favorite game.
Yeah.
No, I like the yelling. I like the yelling.
We're here with Tara and Alexander because they are really the experts on this game. And
oh dear.
For all of the things about this game, it is incredibly complex. We love it so much, but it's so hard to do, and we really need a really good communications officer and a really good captain who is now going to take it away and sort of tell us what the hell we're doing here.
So the game is extremely simple, as long as you don't buy or play it. If you do want to buy or play it, though, it's really, really, really complicated. The game steps you up through a series of different training missions, which we are going to be skipping. So we're going to be going straight into space, which will probably go swimmingly. We're flying a sitting duck class vessel. Does one simple thing. It just hyperspaces out in the middle of nowhere, takes 10 minutes to take a scan of the galaxy, and then hyperspaces back. And we are the crew on this ship. All we have to do is keep the ship together for 10 real-time minutes. Which should probably be very easy, and nothing could possibly go wrong. Usually. In case anything does happen, we have an array of laser cannons and a bunch of energy and pulse cannons, rockets, battle bots, just in case we happen to be attacked by space amoebas or commandos.
For example.
Yeah. That's almost never happened.
Yeah, that rarely happens. Usually it's something much more extreme. The way the game works, though, is and the ship's computer is going to call out things that are happening to the ship during this 10 real-time minute session. During that session, Tara, our communications officer, is going to be keeping track of what the computer says and mapping out as different things come in to attack us. Joe over here is our internal threat officer, and he is going to be taking care of anything that accidentally might happen on the ship.
I think it's...
No, it's this way.
Yeah.
Perfect. In the meantime, Christina over here is our engineering officer, and she does one very important thing. Which seems like it might not be important, but it's actually one of the most important roles on the ship. See, our ship has a very, very powerful computer. The problem with the ship's computer is that it has a screensaver that shows the corporate logo of our sponsor. Unfortunately, the screensaver is really intense. It's a gorgeous logo. But it slows down the ship's computer whenever the screensaver comes on. So we need to make sure Christina is in the bridge to wiggle the mouse. Which is a very important task.
Otherwise, we'll probably all die.
And Justin is going to be our tactical officer. He's going to be helping us after that 10-minute period is up to figure out what the heck just happened and whether or not we survived.
Which is great, because I usually don't know what the heck is happening as it's happening.
So he's more of the debriefing guy after the fact to determine exactly what happened to us.
It turns out we died.
Yeah. Almost certainly.
So the way we play the game, though, is we have these cards, and we're going to be playing these down in front of us as the turns go on. We're not exactly sure what everyone else is playing. Anyone is welcome to say aloud what they've played, but sometimes we lose track, sometimes we forget, sometimes we just do it wrong. All right, I think that's everything. Are you guys ready?
No.
Never.
I think we're as ready as we're going to be, though.
Yes.
So come back, check it out. The link to the playthrough that we're about to start is down below, and we'll see you guys next time.
Team Hypercube out!